Oh. How are the hives?
Unstoppable, apparently. Despite immersions in what seems to be a never-ending series of baths. Let's see, today we had Epsom salt, oatmeal, and baking soda.
Lois must be miserable.
I think it's safe to say she literally wants to jump out of her skin.
Now, what brought this on?
Well, the medics in the family vote for stress, which is a diagnosis I could have made. Between prepping for Miguel's concert, the ongoing tension with Sonny, to say she's a little edgy would be understating.
Yeah, well, you want to talk about edgy, Miguel won't even come to this party with you because he's so angry at Sonny that he just doesn't want to go. I mean, I guess Robin and Stone will understand. They'll understand, right?
Of course. Nobody wants to break up a fight tonight. Hey, since we're both dateless, want to go together?
Yes.
Great. I'll swing by Kelly's tonight at 7.
Perfect.
In the meantime, I have to get back to the house. AJ's head is about to be served up on a platter.
I read about that. What's up with that?
I'd say it's a combination of raging hormones, incredible ignorance, and patterns of a lifetime finally collided in a major way and buried it.
Right. Well, try not to look so pleased about it. I'm gonna go up and see Lois. I'll see you in a little bit.
Look, I realize this is a very grave situation with the Foundation, and that you are all furious with AJ, but I want you to approach this confrontation rationally. Don't rip him to shreds. Let him walk out with some semblance of dignity.
I agree. We should let AJ explain himself before we jump to any conclusions.
Oh, are you people from Mars? There is no explanation. Why it happened does not matter one whit to the media or the people of that community or to the authorities. The only thing that matters is that it did happen.
Edward is right. We also have AJ's uncoerced statement to consider. When he was arrested, he admitted to having approved a grant to one Carla Guthrie for the purposes of opening a temporary employment agency called Fulfillment in a house on Mig Street. He can't unsay it.
Just so there's no misunderstanding, here's my position. As CEO of the funding institution for the Charles Street Development Foundation, all support, financial or otherwise, will be withdrawn unless we have AJ's resignation effective immediately by 5 o'clock today.
Isn't that a bit harsh, Ned?
No, I don't think so. Let the summary execution begin. I swear to all of you, there wasn't one single thing that even whispered suspicion. Now, Carla came into the foundation with a concise, well-thought-out proposal for starting a temp agency. Look, she had experience, she had referrals, all of which I checked out. I double-checked them before submitting her application to the board.
She's telling the truth. We were all impressed by her.
I wouldn't shout that from the rooftop if I were you.
What I'd like to know is, how did you manage to wind up pantless in her house?
Carla invited me over to her house to cook dinner for me as a way of thanking me. Jason and Keisha were right there. I said yes. When I got there, she spilled wine all over my pants, deliberately. I didn't know it at the time, but it turned out to be deliberately. She took the pants, she threw them in the washer. You know the rest.
Well, that sounds innocent enough.
It was. And nobody regrets last night more than I do.
You don't know from regret, but you're about to learn.
Besides, your regret isn't worth the breath it takes to say the word. Now, there may be plausibility in your explanation, but in fact and in essence, you were caught with your pants down, thereby undermining the foundation and the reputations of everyone involved. It was irresponsible. It was self-indulgent. It was...
Stupid seems to work.
It was stupid behavior.
That's enough right there. I take exception with that. I was not careless. I did exactly what I was supposed to do when verifying the information that was given to me. Any one of you would have signed off on that application. You did sign off on it.
As I recall, after your very vocal recommendation.
AJ, the problem is this is not an isolated incident. It is so close, it almost trips over that very unfortunate and very public episode with the federal grant. And when you put the two of them together, the perception is that we are either the biggest
bunch of ignorant blockheads ever to band together in the name of a cause, or the most blatantly corrupt.
This was a setup! Why aren't we using our energy to find out who did this, instead of anointing me the official scapegoat?
And when are you finally going to grow up and take responsibility for your actions?
Today. Now you resign, or we'll force you off the board.
Is that the general consensus?
I'm sorry, AJ. Really, I am. But yes, that's my vote.
I'm sorry, too. But I really don't see any other way, and I've tried.
This is so unfair.
Welcome to the real world, Junior.
I want your resignation by 5 o'clock today.
I'll do better than that, Ned. You'll have it within the hour.
Surprise!
Surprise birthday party.
It's not. It's a party to give you a present.
Actually, it's for both of you.
Yeah! You get the feeling that we've been set up here.
Yes, big time. What do you mean? I don't understand. I thought this was a surprise party for Ron. What did it have to do with me?
A lot. Well, actually, I've invited everybody here today to make a sort of presentation. And that's only fair because, I mean, every single person here has contributed to it one way or another. This is for you. And it's about you. I've been calling it a memory book.
It's a memory book.
Just what it sounds like. Poems, letters, memories. You'll understand more once you read it.
This one's from AJ.
Since it was the inspiration for the book, I thought it should be first.
Come on, sit down. Make yourself comfortable. Yeah. Let's go.
That Miguel sang at the nurse's ball, Power to Believe. There's a note. Dear Stone, this song is on my album, and I've dedicated it to you. When I sing it in concert, it will be for you. Your friend, Miguel. It's really awesome.
He wanted to give you his song.
Hey, this one's from Lucky Spencer. You know, I think that my eyes have been with this light.
Lucky, do you want to read your letter?
Yeah, sure.
It's, Dear Stone, my parents have taught me a lot of things they say are important about getting along with people. When I think of two of them in particular, I think of you. And I know my parents are right, at least about this. My mother says that treat everybody the way you would like to be treated. And my dad says to listen to people. Actually, in his words, he says, shut up and listen to what the other person is trying to tell you. But you know how to do both of these things. And it makes you a really good friend. And I just wanted to tell you that. Sincerely, me.
In many ways, Robin has been my daughter. In all ways, she has been my friend. I have laughed with her and wept for her and worried about her and rejoiced in her. And I've come to understand how deeply and truly she loves you and how much you love her in return. You both grew up so quickly and you continue to grow so bravely. I admire you and I celebrate you both.
Dear Stone, Lois and I agreed we would write this to you together. I am sitting at the computer and she is leaning over the back of my chair and talking nonstop into my ear. A phenomenon with which I know you are familiar and which is endearing when you love her. But it means I'm having a little difficulty collecting my own thoughts, so this won't be as elegant as I'd like it to be. Stone, it's Lois now. In this case, I think we should forget elegant and just go for the heart of the matter, which is we both feel you are such a gift to us. I always wanted a younger brother because older brothers think they know it all. And you are the younger brother of my heart because we share so many interests and ambitions. And I love you very, very much. It's Ned again. This means you're kind of a brother-in-law to me. A great arrangement because I think you're as classy an act as my wife. And more than that, I can't say about anyone. And when the history of L&B Records, Lois here again, is written, there will be a special chapter on Stone and what he has meant to the company and all of us.
Dear Stone, Sigmund asked me to give this to you with love from him and me, Lucy. I bet that you are thunderstruck to read doggerel from a duck. But Lucy's splendid waterfowl is wiser than the wisest owl, more clever far than jay or crow. I'll quack you up with what I know. And what this poem means to tell is, Stone, I think that you are swell. Very truly yours, Sigmund.
Dear Junior, my first impression was that you were a total screw-up. This was also the subject of my first real argument with Corinthos. I did, however, from the start appreciate your style in getting way up in Mac's face. It reminded me of me at your age. My second impression was that Corinthos was right, I was wrong. This happens occasionally. Infrequently. Rarely. But there it was. You had potential. My current impression is that you are a man whom I would be damn grateful to have at my side or guarding my back in perilous times. I wish my friend Robert Scorpio could have known you. I'm glad I do.
Thank you. Guys, I mean, this is just the greatest thing that's ever happened to me. But unless you guys want to see me cry for like the next 2 hours, you gotta let me take this home and I'll read a little bit of it at a time, okay?
All right, let's eat.
I'm just gonna eat until I pass out. Aw, AJ's looking pretty glum.
Tough.
Ned.
Come on, he brought it on himself.
Oh, come on, like you've never made a mistake before?
Not like that.
Oh, well, excuse me, but I seem to remember a certain little trip to Boston with, what was that little tramp's name? Gretchen, Gretel, Bertha.
All right, that's it. That's it, right there.
Okay,
no
I'm sorry.
More.
I'm sorry.
Give up.
I'm sorry.
Uncle.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Spreading the wealth around, Brenda? I'm not surprised Miguel isn't enough for you. Where's your wife, Ashton?
Were you here for the raffle?
What raffle?
Earlier. No, I don't think you were. Well, guess what? You won the door prize.
Boom!
Oh, oh,
hey,
hey.
Oh, whoa!
Dad.
Yep.
I owed you that, Corinthos.
Come on, it's okay. A party now. It's a party, okay?
Hey, hey!
Oh, my God! Alan!
Come on, no!
Don't even.
You still owe me, tough guy.
Take it easy.
You okay?